Hey there, this video right here is just part of the complete comparison. So should you ever feel like watching the whole thing, it's waiting for you in the top right hand corner. Just wanted to let you know.
The 11-22 has a nice metallic taupe finish. The focus ring moves perfectly. Not too loose, not too tight, super smooth, which is awesome. Also, it has a nice thickness to it, so it's easy to pull focus with this lens. The mount is metal, durable and stable. Now, to use it, you have to place it into its shooting position, which will extend the lens barrel, like so. And when using the zoom ring, the lens barrel moves a little as well. Now that's the 10-18 with the adapter. The finish of the lens, the finish of the adapter perfectly match the finish of the M50 body. So the three of those aesthetically are a nice combo. Focus ring doesn't move as smoothly as with the 11-22 and is also thinner, although the whole lens is bigger, which is kind of a bummer because pulling focus manually with the 11-22 is a pleasure. Here you kind of have to get used to it. Zoom ring feels nice. There is no shooting position, you can use it as is, but when using the zoom ring, the lens barrel extends and retracts a little. With the adapter on it, you get a mount on the adapter, which is super awesome because once it's on the M50 body, and which is the kicker, you have a quick release plate that is slim enough and mounted like this, you can now access the battery and SD card slot, which you couldn't if you had to apply the quick release plate to the camera body, which you would have to if you would use the 11-22. So for somebody who is terribly annoyed that they have to take the quick release plate off to reach the battery and the SD card, actually the 10-18 in combination with the adapter is awesome. If you have a quick release plate that is rather slim, you can get those for a couple of bucks. So that's really an upside handling wise for the 10-18 adapter combo, the biggest one in my opinion. Of course, form factor wise, this is way bulkier. It's a completely different look. Of course, the camera is more front heavy, but then again, we're talking about 200 grams, so you're not gonna strain your wrist too much. However, if you need the most compact form factor, obviously the 11-22 beats the 10-18 adapter combo because you're not gonna get a more compact setup than this while still having a super wide angle on your camera body. It fits perfectly and is aesthetically very pleasing. This is how it looks when you use it. But if you have to put it away, this is as compact as you're gonna get with a super wide angle and the Canon mirrorless series. Now, something I really, really like when it comes to handling is manual buttons on the lens body itself. With the 10-18, you can quickly turn on or off stabilization and switch between manual focus and autofocus because there's dedicated buttons on the lens body. Now, the 11-22 doesn't have such buttons. To access the same functions, you either have to do a menu dive or find a clever way to map these functions to the camera buttons.
So, if you liked the video, if you found it helpful, please make sure to leave a thumbs up. It's greatly appreciated. Any kind of comment or feedback is welcome, and I'll try to answer as quickly as possible. All the tech that I've used in this video is linked in the description. As always, thank you so much for your time. Thank you for watching, and hopefully see you again soon.